So we start this morning session about boot. We are all here from Red Hat to work on several different components of how to improve the Linux system boot over the past years. And to work on GNUBoot, PHI, other UDF, systemd, key modifications to DFHS, and finally Red Hat, which is going to be the topic of today's talk. So please welcome Harold.
I'll talk about Red Hat, which is a generic cross-distribution in environment-first generator. The main benefits for Debian to use Red Hat as an environment-first generator is the unification for to use the same tools on nearly all distributions. And we can have concerted support to improve the software, of course. Drake is able to handle very difficult storage combinations because it's event-based with UDEV, and in the last year gained also systemd capabilities and integrates nicely into the systemd infrastructure. We also gain the benefits of having systemd in the environment. Red is able to boot from LVM on MVRAID, on DMRAID. You can stack everything like you want. As long as you specify every parameters on the kernel command line how to assemble those devices, like specifying UUIDs for the RAID, or specifying volume names or for LVM. And there's another mode which is called host only. They can celebrate it. Generally, an InEnvironFS which is only for this machine with this disk layout, and Drake will find everything about it on the disk, and you don't have to specify anything on the kernel command line except the root equals the root file system. Internally, Drake has a very extensive test suite. So it starts virtual machines, which boot, and even starts NFS servers or iSCSI servers, and they talk to each other, the virtual machines. So we can make sure that the release is stable and no regressions are put in the last code. Break it is very fast. If you boot it with systemd, because then there's no shell script involved in the simple cases, and it's even faster than booting the kernel without an InEnvironFS. So for the simple case like a ButterFS volume or X4, the kernel is slower than the combination of the kernel and the InEnvironFS. Could maybe be fixed in the kernel to get the same speed, but currently, at this point of time, it's faster. Drake is very well documented for the user, but not so for the developer, because it's shellcode and very easy to read. So I can give you a peek of the documentation, which is shipped in the package. It's very long, and you even have an overview how the boot is going in systemd setups. Yeah, in systemd we have a tight integration because we work very closely together. And if you have systemd in Debian and use Red Hat, you get all the benefits, like early logging with the journal. We have state introspection afterwards. If you are at the reboot, you can see which Drake service units have been started and what the output was. And what has never been done before, I think, you can, on Fedora, if you do the Fedora, it disassembles all the root device components on shutdown. So you can tell the iSCSI server, okay, I'm done with that volume, or the NFS server, this is finished now, and you get a clean state for the next boot. Also for MD rates, it's very crucial to wait until everything has synced before you disassemble it or reboot, so that you don't have to sync with the next reboot. The features of Brigit that you can build, like I said before, host-only images, which are very small, very specific, and only include the kernel modules which you need to boot that machine, but only that specific machine, and with that specific disk layout or assembly layout. You can also build a generic one, which has all the modules you normally need, like LVM, MD-Wave, whatever. And nothing is pre-configured in the inner drum of S. So every configuration, how those this RAID or this LVM is assembled, has to be specified on the kernel command line. So you say, I want all RAID members with RAID UUID, blah, 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 assembled. I want to activate these volume groups, or I want to activate these logical volumes. And that is the case of a generic one, which you can ship and just copy on most of the computers and just put anything which you have on disk, as long as you know the UUIDs or the names. Then you can also build rescue systems with it very easily. You can include boot charts, help us with systemd. There's systemd boot chart, and for non-systemd systems, there was the old boot chart from Ubuntu, maybe, which you can include in the inner drum, so you get an idea how the boot looks like even in your inner drum OS. Brigit supports FIPS, which is certification for government machines. You can drop the capabilities on non-systemd setups for the real root. So maybe you want to load all the kernel modules in the inner DNFS which you want to use, and drop the capability of the whole system to load any module ever on the real root. So you can have a fixed set of modules which cannot be altered. It supports internationalization, not so much now on Debian, because some of the parts of the keyboard layouts and fonts are not that common between distributions. That's maybe one reason to have one layout for all distributions, to have such tools work without problems. It has a network stack in it. It's none of the, because it has to be cross distributions, we had to have some minimal network stack, not copied from Debian or Red Hat, or we just made another one. So we hope that maybe we get the system needs on network capabilities at some point of time, so that in systemd environments we have a common network set up even with the real system. Brigit supports boot splash programs like Plymouth or Gen Splash, which is from Gentoo, which display my splash screen and even ask for the password if you have an encrypted disk. Brigit supports Esperanto, Setsu, with the various IBM disks, and that works. It supports maybe bcache already, ButterFS of course, and ButterFS on multiple devices, which is not so common. It supports, of course, CryptoLux, DMRAID, and NVRAID. GameSquash Live is something how we build our live CDs on Fedora, where you have a SquashFS image which you overlay with some DN overlay with a persistent storage. When you have your live USB stick, you can have a persistent storage. Then, of course, it supports LVM, multipath, ZipRS, private channel over internet, iSCSI, NVD, NFS, and resuming from disk. Resuming from disk is not so easy as it looks like, because you have to wait until all the swap partitions show up so that you can scan if there is a signature from a validation image. It supports various security file systems, BIOS name if you want that, but I wouldn't recommend that. The ECRIP file system, SAD Linux, of course. You can even have syslog in there for the non-systemd systems. And of course, systemd is supported. And with our user merge, we had to mount slash user from within the inner run of S. Same has to be done maybe on Debian 2 if you have a split user, because Drake has to know how to, in systemd environments, has to know how to assemble, or how to activate the slash user LVM logical volume, because it seems like Debian does not do that before it tries to mount every FS top entry. Drake has been in Fedora since version 12, which is a long time now. In Red Hat Enterprise Linux since version 6, in Gentoo since 2010, and in Debian since Squeeze, I think. And we are 2012. OpenSUSE wants to switch to Drake, but they are lazy. They just want to keep what they have, but they always, every time they say, yes, we want to switch, but nobody's doing it. And why they not switch is the other one. There are over 100 individual contributors to Grey Hat, and for example, in the last 12 months there have been 37. And now I'm going to show a small demo, which is always critical. Well, I will boot a normal Debian, the file system now, with an encrypted disk, and with an LVM layout on top of it. So you see there's a slash user, and it's an LVM with multiple logical volumes. I just checked out the Git repository, and I'm going to run Grake from within the Git repository without installing it on the real system, so it doesn't sample your installation.
Wait.
Oh,
it's just
that
you cannot read the screen.
Oh,
the
screen
is unreadable?
Yes. Can you switch to black and white? That's true, maybe. But I don't think I can change the console. Okay, so that demo is, well, not so useful for you. In the back rooms, make it useful. But just to show that it works, I will select the grub entry with my bracket lim-valve as, and you also have to put in the password to encrypt the disk, and then it works.
That's what you said.
That's what I said, yeah. Of course, I couldn't lie. Same thing with the Debian installation with systemd installed. Just put in the password. And you're done. And it even was faster than before. Maybe. How to get into the ILVANFS without you can set breakpoints in the ILVANFS. rd.break you just put on the current command line. And you have a shell in the ILVANFS before it switches to reboot. You can introspect the journal. English layout, which is very nice from within the ILVANFS. You get all the nice systemd features of journal. And of course, system control also works. Well, basically, that's what I have. I would have shown you more if you could read it. You're welcome to contribute to the Breakthrough project. It's on hello.org. It has a wiki page where you can find all the links. The download directory is also on hello.org, and the Git repository is also on GitHub and on SourceForge. And it's all synced and the same. So, do you have any questions about it? Now that I'm here, it's the right time to pose any questions.
So, I don't have any question to you, but if somebody likes to use Raycard with Debian or want to help, I'm the maintainer of the Raycard package, and the current status is that 0.31 is upstream version, and this is also the version that we have in unstable. And the only thing I would say that's currently not working in Debian is the i18n internationalization support, but I'm working on this, and I think in 2 weeks this is fixed. So just grab the package and try it. I use Raycard for nearly all my machines and notebooks since over 1 year, and I have no problems. What's also very nice is a debugging support with rd-break. Yeah, but just try it, and if you have any questions which are Debian related for the package, you can just contact me. or Haraku. That's really, for me as the package maintainer, it was really nice to see that the cooperation was very easy. So between distributions, Fedora, Debian, that's really nice work. Thank you, Haraku.
You're welcome. Because of Debian, which has another name for your rule files for DM and for LVM, there's a problem currently with the current version that it does not include the UDIF rules. So you might want to try the GitHub or the next version.
31.
That, oh, yeah. Oh, yes. Sorry. Yeah.
Also, might want to stop making it elegant. So you might want to stop renaming the rules to make that elegant. I
mean, it's still small.
Oh, sorry.
Does it work?
Yeah. Debian, for some reason, decides to rename upstream unit rules to something they think it's elegant.
We're working on it.
And this is really, it's no point. It makes something, things so difficult. We just see no point.
I think I can answer that. We're working on it, but it's a hard problem because you need to make sure that nothing breaks in process. But we're confident that we will arrive at the upstream rules eventually.
Not only the UDIF package, but also like LVM and the device in general. People think they have nicer names than upstream, but it's not the case.
So I actually have a question maybe for you as the maintainer. As far as I remember, there are some packages in Debian that ship hooks for the inner ground class. For example, there's the drop gear thing that allows you to do remote crypto unlock on boot, which I actually use, and it's pretty nice. Is that working with Rika currently?
I did not use this, so we have to try it. What's really nice working is the drop-in scripts for the regeneration of datagram address, if you have a new kernel package and so on. Mm-hmm. But yeah, let's try this. And I can really say most things was very easy to adjust or to
okay, great. To be a cross generic for cross distribution generic in the kernel as generator, we put all the scripts from the packages in the integrated itself first. And then we try to move that to the other packages. But I don't think your plugin will work anymore.
Sorry, just to make that clear, there is no hook mechanism in bracket. There is no hook mechanism
there
in bracket.
Are hooks, yes, but they are not the same like in your environment as the infrastructure we should currently have. There are hooks, of course. It's a different system.
So the modules themselves are kind of hooks.
The modules are themselves like hooks.
Yeah. So the entirety of Tracker is like only hooks. It's just different from what they are.
Any more questions? Yes.
Is RD dot break a target feature or is it generic kernel feature?
It's a target feature because the kernel has booted in a kernel test, so it can't be a kernel feature. It's a target feature.
Okay, thank you.
I prefix all the kernel command line options which are for bracket with RD dots so you can easily tell them apart from the rest.
I just happen to be maintaining natural body parts, and I have written some support for MVD into MK in MLS, so you can put it there. I know there is some support for MVD in Dracula as well.
Yes.
Is there any documentation that I can read on that so I can make it at least a command line compatible?
The kernel command line options are well documented.
Oh, okay.
Where
is this? I'll look at that.
You mentioned you have some test suites. Are they running on what kind of operating system do you use for your test suites?
My test suite I run on Fedora, but it should easily be it can easily be run on Debian too, because it uses just standard tools. There's a README for the test suite, which components you have to install, like the servers, the iSCSI server or the NP server or what else. There might be problems if you have the configuration files, if you have them in different places by default. That's always the problem, changing names from the upstream. So maybe Fedora diverts from the upstream, maybe Debian diverts from it. So that's the only problem you will have with the test suite. Of course, there's one test with RPM, which you can skip, of course. Yeah. More questions? If not, then thank you, and I hope you will adapt to break it.
I have one thing to say. There's a breakout above, I think at 3:30 p.m. today, where I like to discuss what should be done or what has to be done to make breakout the default Integrand FS, or do we want this? So if you'd like to discuss this question, please join the bot at 3:30 p.m. today.
Thank you.
The next